This is my hood, man. Like, I get love from my hood. Like, I'm not afraid of anywhere I go. Like, you can't live your life being afraid. If my life get taken tomorrow, then it's meant to be. Like, that ain't the worst thing that could happen. Then this little nigga gonna take over. And then he gonna take over. And then whoever else is around me is gonna take over. It's not about me. I'm just here, the physical contribution to the hood.
Yeah. Straight off the plane. Dropping the flame. Ferg.
Yeah, this is where I'm from. Like, this is my block, 143rd. Between Amsterdam and Broadway, Hamilton. They call it Hungry Ham. Cause everybody over here go ham for their hungriness. This is where we shot Pesos. And Rocky was coming out the door like, I beat that pretty mother. You know what I'm saying? And Ty Beats with his big old head was coming out the door. Yeah, it's a lot of history being made on this corner right here. And then you had like my pops. He used to live in that red building down there. Like, that's where my moms met him and shit. Like, he was getting his ones up. Seen a fine little pretty thing walking down the block. Hollered at her. And, you know, that's how I came about. Yo, what's good, big?
What's going on?
Little complex shit.
How we do it out here in the hood, my nigga? How we do it?
Hell yeah, let me get in the ride with you.
I think she going brains. Put it in work. Put him in that dirt. See me going squirt. Damn, he got hurt.
Yo, we gonna put him in the dirt.
You already know, bro. Going hell. Kids don't do that shit. That's hood shit right there.
If I die before I wake, I pray that ASAP will be great. My mama good and my girl be late, so it'll be another meet.
All right, so we on 143rd in Hamilton. We call this the island. It's like a little triangular shape, like little island in the middle of the two streets, the intersection. And this is where I shot 100 million roses and shit. I was drinking that Bugatti and I got so fucked up, I was just on the cross like this, shooting the whole video. And it was crazy, like my barber came outside, he stopped cutting hair because he thought I was dying. My mother was looking outside of the motherfucking window to make sure I was okay. I was just out here, bruh, cuts and bruises like I was from 300. Alright, this guy right here is Jay West, my brother. He been there, like, you know, through thick and thin. And this is my heart. For real.
We met actually in Art and Design High School. So it was one of those things where it was like, we were both creative and just clashed and just became brothers, like, through the years. Up front here, I'd be painting, and like, back there, D would be, like, screen printing and making shirts. And then we'll probably switch roles. When he was tired of printing and stuff like that, I'd go back there and do some shirts, and he'd be helping me with paintings. So it was always a creative environment, you know what I'm saying? Like, we was down here till wee hours in the morning just doing everything. Spray painting, my mom's coming downstairs talking about the fumes and stuff.
Well, art was my first love, and it still is my first love. Music is just a different expression of art that I can create sonically now. And I used to take the thank you come again signs from out the street, and they put them outside of the like bodega stores. And I used to just like rip them out the wall, like unscrew them out the wall, and just like take them home, paint them, put it back inside the frame, and put it back outside the stores.
He's always been like super creative, so I never had to pull his teeth about any visions. He usually comes to me with a lot of visions, and it's like, yo, this is crazy. It's never like a compromise. So we work well creatively together.
I'm good at doing this shit, like at anything I do, but like when we put our minds together, it just becomes better.
So much more magical.
Yo, what Mr. Remsen told you in school?
He told me like, yo, you know, when your moms try to give you these directions or force you in a way, she gotta understand that your story is your story. You gotta do it how you do it.
Our mothers think that we don't give a fuck about nothing. Like.
Yeah, and before everything popped, they always had that idea like, yo, they gonna do what they want. Like, I gotta stop trying to force them in this direction. Like, we just been relentless about this, you know what I mean? Like, we had a crazy determination and it's not letting up.
I'm into like stuff that evokes emotion. I love music, but it's like now it's like, it's a job now for me. This is how I gotta support myself. So for me to go back and paint is like an escape from my job. Hey yo, we about to go to my school, Our Lady of Lords. Lords Never Worry. It was a girl I had a crush on named Stephanie. And I remember like, we used to get free dress day cause you used to have to wear uniform all the time. So we used to have to do mass like every Thursday. And I remember we did mass, and I wore my Coogi pants. And like all the teachers and like my gym teacher was like, ooh, those cost a lot of money, because you know, Coogi is like $500-$600 for a pair of pants. My pops got them for me, and I wore them in church, and she would just kept touching my pants. She's touching my legs, and I was like, ooh, she liked me. There used to be a bunch of little bitches I used to like in there. I remember that shit. Not the nuns. I never did First Communion or nothing like that, but we had to study religion. My mother is not a church-going woman. She believe in God, but she don't go to my mother do not leave the house. Like, I had to force her to come to my video shoot yesterday. Like, French Montana, all these big people. She said, French my who? I always got this theory. She's never been to one of my shows. I said, she only gonna see me perform when I, like, get to the Grammys or some shit like that. Like, my teachers used to get mad test papers with mad doodling and Dragon Ball Z characters on them shits. I used to draw on a desk, if that's some artistic shit. I used to draw on a desk in this school, but like, nothing about the school sparked, nothing about my artistic process. This ain't do nothing. I'm sorry, I just went to this school, so I'm explaining like about Our Lady of Lourdes. But it's all, yeah. Yes, I'm an alumni.
Especially with this alcohol and
oh, that wasn't even ours.
Coochie down to the socks like I'm Biggie Popper. Keep your girl head in my Tommy boxes. But when it out, she a silly house.
Do you see me, greet me like you fam, not a fan.
It's matter of fact, get them facts right. Coming through with the fucking gun all the night. Do you want your life? Do you want your life? Tell me, nigga. When I got that heat up, you know that Tommy Hill figure.
ASAP Ferg the God.
We ASAP.
We ASAP.
Bitch. Swag, swag, you heard?
Don't talk to me at all.
Shout out to Complex.com, you heard?